Hello friends, welcome back to All About Structural Analysis and Design. So we were seeing about the slope deflection method and we have seen previous videos based on slope deflection method. So previous two problems were based on two span continuous beam, and I have shown you the detailed steps how to calculate the end moments and also how to draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. So in this today's problem, we will take up three span continuous beam and we will try to solve by slope deflection method. Okay, so here there is a three span beam and the loadings are also different. Okay, so first one is UDL, so second loading is symmetrical loading. Okay, and third is unsymmetrical loading on that particular third span. Okay, so this we have to solve by slope deflection method, and to know the steps and to know in detail the procedure of slope deflection method, I will be sharing the link in the description box of all the videos of slope deflection method. So you can go through those videos and be perfect on those particular problems also. So let's start with today's problem. So this is the given beam, and the first step in the slope deflection method is to calculate the fixed end moments. So I have explained everything what is meant by fixed end moments and all in the previous videos. So you can just look onto those videos. So here the fixed end moments will be MFAB. So the first fixed end moment will be for the UDL and it is minus WL square by 12. Okay, so it is for AB. So that's why this the fixed end moments will be anti-clockwise in direction. So that's why it is minus. And one more, the fixed end moments will be here. It will be in clockwise direction. So it will be plus. So the general formula for UDL is WL square by 12. Okay, so here we will substitute the W, it is minus 30. Then L is 4. Okay, so this comes out to be minus 40 kilonewton meter. Similarly, now MFBA, okay, so MFBA, so it will be positive WL square by 12. So load remains same, span remains same, so it is positive 40 kilonewton meter. So next loading condition is point loads, which is placed at the center, and for that particular fixed end moments, so this will be MFBC. So the formula is minus WL by 8. So here W is 60, again span is 4 meters, right, divided by 8. So this comes out to be minus 30 kilonewton meter. And next will be MFCB. It is positive WL by 8 because it is clockwise direction. So it will come positive 30 kilonewton meter. So next, it is very important to know the fixed end moment formula first, because it is not acting at the center. So it is acting at a point where the lengths are unequal. So for these kind of fixed end moments, you have to remember the formula. Okay, so MFCD will be minus WAB square by L square, and the substitution becomes minus 60. Now A is here 2 meters, B is here 4 meters. So this you have to be careful while substituting in the equation. So A is 2 here, so 60 into 2, and B is 4 here. So 4 square divided by total length is 4 plus 2, 6 meters. So this comes out to be minus 53.33 kilonewton meter. So now when you find out the fixed end moments for this particular DC, so it will be positive, but the formula will not remain same as it was case in UDL and point load at the center. So here it was same, but only signs were changing. So that's why I have not shown the substitution, but here you have to show the substitution clearly. So here it becomes MFDC. It will remain positive because it will rotate, the fixed end moment will rotate clockwise. So it is WA square B by L square. Okay, so this you have to carefully remember. So 60 into 2 square into 4 divided by 6 square. So this comes out to be 26.67 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is how your first step in the slope deflection method, we have to do it. to find out the fixing end moments or fixed end moments. Now you have to check out where all theta is zero. So in this problem, again, sink is not given. So they have not mentioned anything, the support is sinking and all. So that means the delta will be zero. And now you have to check out where all theta will be zero. So in this case, only A end is fixed. Okay, so B, C, D all are, what you can say. So BC is roller and D is hinge. So it means theta A only will be zero in this case. So therefore, end A is fixed. Therefore, theta A is equals to zero. And also delta is equals to zero. So they have not mentioned anything. So we are taking delta is equals to zero. So now you have to note down the slope deflection equations one by one. Also the derivation, I have shown the how it comes or how we derive the equations. So the links all will be shared in the description box and also in the playlist of slope deflection method. So now the slope deflection equation we have to write here. So for the moment MAB, the equation will be, so MF AB plus 2EI by L 2 theta A plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. So this is the slope deflection equation for the moment at AB. Okay. So now you have to write down here the fixed end moments for AB. So that we had calculated as minus 40. Okay. So you have to check out here what all the I values are given. So for in this particular problem, so span AB is having I value 1. BC I value 1 and for CD the I value is 2. So appropriately I values you have to substitute in the slope deflection equation. Okay, so don't forget to see in the question what all things are given. So here the span AB is having I value 1, so it will remain 2EI by L. L was 4 meters. So now in this case theta A is 0, delta A is 0, so only remaining part will be theta B. So this will come out to be minus 40 plus 0.5 EI theta B. So this will be your equation number 1. So next now you have to find out for MBA. So the equation becomes MFBA plus 2 EI by L. Now 2 times theta B plus theta A minus 3 delta by L. So this is the slope deflection equation for point BA. Okay, so here again you have to substitute, so this is plus 40 here, so again this will remain 2 EI by 4, then theta A and delta A is 0, so remaining will be theta B. So this comes out to be 40 plus EI theta B. So this will remain equation number 2. Now you have to find out MBC. So MFBC plus 2EI by L 2 theta B plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. So in this equation you have to remember theta B is also not equal to 0, theta C is also not equal to 0. So but only delta is 0, so theta B and theta C will remain in this particular equation. So now you have to substitute here MFBC and it was minus 30. I value was again 1 for span BC. Okay, so 2EI by the span was 4, 2 theta B plus theta C, right? So this comes out to be minus 30 plus EI theta B, right? And plus 0.5 EI theta C. So this comes out to be equation number 3. Next is MCB. So MFCB plus 2EI by L 2 theta C plus theta B minus 3 delta by L. So here you have to substitute 30 plus 2EI by 4, right? 2 theta C plus theta B. So this comes out to be 30 plus 0.5 EI theta B plus EI theta C. So this will become equation number 4. Next is एम सी डी एम एफ सी डी प्लस टू ई आई बाई एल टू थीटा सी प्लस थीटा डी minus 3 delta by L. So in this equation also delta is 0, but theta c and theta d will remain because it was not a fixed end. So here you can substitute. So mf cd value was minus 53.33 plus 2e, I value was 2, right? So 2e I by 6, right? Then 2 theta c plus theta d. So this comes out to be minus 53.33 plus 1.33 EI theta C, then plus 0.67 EI theta D. So this comes out to be equation number 5. The last moment equation is MDC. Then you have to write down here MFDC plus 2EI by L 2 theta D plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. So here the fixed end moment for DC was 26.67 plus 2E I is 2 for span B, CD, right? Span is 6 meters. 2 theta t plus theta c. So this will become 26.67 plus 0.67 EI theta c plus 1.33 EI theta d. So this will become equation number 6. Now what happens here? You have to use the equations of equilibrium. So at point B, the moment should be 0. At point C, the moment should be 0, and at point D, the moment should be 0. And for to make it 0, so MBA plus MBC will be the first equilibrium condition at point B. Then MCB plus MCD will be equal to 0 at point C. And then the last equilibrium condition at point D, that will be MDC equal to 0. So these three equations of equilibrium, so these three conditions you will be using, and you will be finding the new three equations where theta B, theta C and theta D will be present, and you can input that in calculator and find out the value of theta B, theta C and theta D. So let's calculate those things. So now equilibrium condition at B. At B, MBA plus MBC equals to 0. So this is nothing but this equation number 2 and equation number 3, you have to equate it to 0. Okay. So MBA was 40 plus EI theta B minus 30 plus EI theta B plus 0.5 EI theta C is equal to 0. So you can rearrange the term now. So 2 EI theta B plus 0.5 EI theta C is equals to minus 10. So this will be your equation number 7. Okay. So now next thing is at equilibrium condition at C. At C will be MCB plus MCD equals to 0. So those two equations, so which is nothing but MCB is equation number 4, MCD is equation number 5. So these 4 and 5 equations you have to take and you have to equate it to 0. Okay. So these equations will be 30, right, plus 0.5. EI theta B plus EI theta C minus 53.33 plus 1.33 EI theta C plus 0.67 EI theta D is equals to 0. So you can rearrange the term and those equation and this equation will be 0.5 ei theta b plus 2.33 ei theta c plus 0.67 ei theta d is equals to 23.33. So this will be your equation number 8. And now that last point at d, so there is only one span, that is mdc equals to 0. So this will be mdc equation number 6, right? 0.67. So directly I will rearrange the term here, ei theta c plus 1.33 ei theta d is equals to minus 26.67. So this will be your equation number 9. So now solving 7, 8 and 9. So in calculators, you can choose the mode, okay, equation mode, and you can just input the equation 7, 8, 9 in appropriate order and get the values of theta c, theta d and theta b, okay. So once you input into the calculator the values of 7, 8, 9 equation, you will be getting the value of ei theta b as minus 10.25, ei theta c will be 21.02, and ei theta d will be minus 30.64. So these are the three values you have got: minus 10.25, minus 21.02 and minus 30.64. So now what you have to do, you have to substitute these value in the equations 1, 2, 6. So now substitute in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6th equation and get the values of final moment. So once you substitute these three values in these six equations, you will be getting the values. So MAB, the value will be minus 45.125 kilonewton meter. Okay. Then MBA value will be 29.75 kilonewton meter. Next, MBC value will be minus 29.75 kilonewton meter. MCB will be 45.895 kilonewton meter. MCD will be minus 45.9 kilonewton meter, and MDC will be 0. So once you check out this, we had used this equilibrium condition, MBA plus MBC is equals to 0. So once you add these two values, you will be getting 0. So at point B it is 0, at point C it is 0, and at point D is equals to 0. So now once you get these final moments, you have to draw the bending moment diagram and shear force diagram. So first we will see the bending moment diagram first. So what I'll do is, okay, so neatly you have to draw the SFD and BMD. So as we have completed with the end moments, so we will draw the BMD first. And to draw the BMD, you need the bending moment values for the loading conditions, that is initial loading condition, whatever is given on the beam. And for UDL, it is WL square by 8. And if you do those calculations, you will be getting the value of 60 kilonewton meter, and it will be a parabola. So 60 kilonewton meter, you have to draw it. So this will be your 60 kilonewton meter parabolic bending moment diagram. Okay. And next is point load, that will be PL by 4. So 60 into 4 divided by 4. So it will be a 60 again. So here you can mark it. So same level you should do it. So this will be your 60 kilonewton meter point load bending moment diagram. Next will be WAB by L. So it will be a 80. So it should cross this one 60 here. So you can mark here. So this will be your triangular bending moment diagram for this loading condition, which is not at the center. So this is 80 kilonewton meter. So now you have to make use of these six moment end moments values and you have to draw the bending moment diagram. So now one simple sign convention I want to show you here how to draw it. So whenever you are overlapping the moment values, so what you can do is you can draw the separate beams here like this. Okay, so this is nothing but AB, BC beam and CD beam. Okay, so three beams I have done separately here. So what you can follow his sign conventions. So minus, plus, plus, minus. So same thing you can write down for all the three spans. Okay, so now what is happening is, so our value of MAB is minus 45.125 and minus sign here is at the top for AB. So what you can do, so minus 45.125 is top of this reference line. So I'll mark here somewhere, so it should be less than 60. So somewhere this point I will mark here. So it will be 45.125 kilonewton meter. So this is clear now. So next is MBA. So MBA is 29.75 and BA is nothing but this, and it is positive, and positive is above this reference line. So you have to somewhere mark here. So the 29 will be coming somewhere at this point. Next is MBC, and MBC is minus 29.75. So BC is minus again top of this reference line. So it will coincide with this particular point. So next is MCB, it is 45.895. So CB is positive. So positive is above this reference line. So this you have to mark here. So CB, so 45. So almost at the same level like this, you have to mark here. Next, what you have to see is MCD. So MCD, again, it is minus value, and here the minus value lies above this reference line. So again, it will coincide with this particular point. And the last is MDC is zero. Okay, no need to check again the signs. So these will be the points. So you can just join these particular points. So this first point, next it will go like this. Then it will meet at this point. And the last point was zero. So this will be your bending moment diagram. So you can, here you can write down the values. It was 29.75 kilonewton meter. And this is 45.9 kilonewton meter. So this will be your bending moment diagram. So you can shade these portions, which will be very important. So this is your zero. So this is how you have to complete the bending moment diagram once you get the end moments. Okay, so this is the sign conventions which I'll be following in all the next lectures. Okay, so it is very convenient to remember and also very convenient to apply in while drawing the bending moment diagram. So once you have drawn the bending moment diagram, then we have to go for the drawing of shear force diagram. And for that, you need the vertical reactions. So I will mark on this particular diagram itself. So this will be your vertical reaction VA, okay, VB, VC and VD. Also, I will mark here the end moments. So MAB was minus 45. So it is anti-clockwise here. Okay, so 45.125. Next is MBA, positive 29, so it is clockwise, 29.75. Next is minus, so here it is anti-clockwise. This is again plus 45.9. So this is again 45.9 and it is zero. Okay, so this is how you have to first mark the reactions and the moments which you have got. So I'll be finding out the reactions for the span AB first. Okay, to find reactions. Right, so I will make sigma MB is equals to zero. Okay, so I'll be following this kind of sign conventions. So if you are taking section at left hand side, so clockwise will be positive. If you are taking section at right hand side, anti-clockwise will be positive. So now what you have to do, so you have to keep your finger and check what all the forces are rotating at point B. So this will be VA into 4. So VA is rotating clockwise, so it will be VA into 4. Next is, this is moment is rotating again anti-clockwise, so minus 45.125. So this 30 kilonewton meter is UDL, so it is again rotating anti-clockwise. So minus 30 into 4 acting at a distance 2 meters. Then this is acting again clockwise, so plus 29.75 is equals to 0. So you get here VA is equals to 63.84 kilonewton. So this is your value for VA. So now for next reaction calculation, so I'll be taking moment at sigma MC is equals to 0. So VA and VB will come into picture, and VB will be unknown, and we'll be calculating the value of VB. Okay. So here I will write down sigma MC is equals to 0. VA is rotating at a distance of 8 meters. Right. So then again this minus 45.125 moment. So next will be 30 into 4, and it will rotate at a distance of 6 meters, 2 meters this on this span and 4 meters on this span. Then this is rotating clockwise, so plus 29.75. So this is again anti-clockwise, minus 29.75. And this VB is rotating at a distance 4 meters. So plus VB into 4. Then again the 60 is rotating anti-clockwise. So minus 16 to 2, right? So this 45.9, again it is rotating clockwise. So 45.9 positive. So once you work out this, you will be getting, so VA you can substitute 63.84, and VB you will be getting around 82.12 kilonewton. So next, the reaction we will find out is VD, and you can take the sigma MC is equals to 0 and right hand side of the section, and right hand side of the section is anticlockwise positive. VD is rotating at a distance of 6 meters, which is rotating anticlockwise. So here I will write down again sigma MC is equals to 0. So VD is rotating at a distance of 6 meters. The 60 is rotating clockwise at a distance 2 meters. So minus 60 into 2, then this is 0, we will not consider, and this is rotating again anti-clockwise plus 45.9 is equals to 0. So this VD comes out to be 12.35 kilonewton. So next you can calculate VC. So VA minus 30 into 4, then plus VB minus 60 plus VC minus 60 plus VD is equals to 0. In this VA, VB, VD, you can substitute and calculate the VC value. So it comes out to be 81.69 kilonewton. Okay, so this is how you will be getting all the four vertical components, and then you can draw the shear force diagram. So one by one, I will show you how to draw it. So here you can draw the shear force diagram. So VA was 63.84. It was going upwards because it was positive. So you can draw here and mark here 63.84 kilonewton. Then this UDL is acting 30 into 4. That is 120, and it is linear moment. So it will come out to be 56 minus 56.16. So you can join like this. Then again VB is positive, and it was 82.12. So minus 56.16 plus 82.12, you will be getting 25.96. So you can go up again. So 25.96. Then till 2 meters, there is no load. So you can continue here straight line for 2 meters. then you have to go minus 60, so you'll be getting value 34.04 kilonewton. So this will be 34.04 kilonewton. So again, there is no load for this 2 meter distance, so straight line. So then plus VC, and VC was 81.69, so minus 34.04 plus 81.69 comes out to be 47.65. So here you can mark 47.65 kilonewton. So again, for 2 meters there is no load, so this straight line will continue for 2 meters. So then minus 60, there it will be 12.35, right? And then 4 meters there is no load, so it will continue like this. And the last is VD is equals to 12.35. So again, it will come back and meet at this point. So this will be 0. So this will be 12.35 kilonewton. So these things will be positive, negative, positive, negative, positive, negative. So this is how you have to draw the shear force diagram. And this completes your analysis of three span continuous beam by slope deflection method. I hope you have understood this problem. If you have understood this problem, please like it, share it, and don't forget to subscribe All About Structural Analysis and Design. And also press the bell icon for the latest notifications of my videos in civil and structural engineering. Thank you, friends.